The book. Thank you. usually technology fails and we have to have a backup. In this case, I printed out my awards list and promptly forgot to grab it from the printer. So I went and retrieved my iPad, and that's what I was messing with. So I apologize for the delay, but we'll go through the awards quickly. This has been a great year, and this is the time of year when we honor everyone at the end of the year and recognize them. We've brought out the trophies that we've earned at the Raging Red, so that if any of you want to look at those, they're up here afterwards. When the individual awards are given out, we'll bring them up to front stage right here. So if you want to take any pictures, you can come up at that time and take a photo. If it's your child or you're related to them, we'll get away from this stand here. For the letter winners, they will come up and retrieve their bars and pins. They're just going to line up here. You guys can line up in two rows. Some of you go on the bottom, some of you on the top. So we'll go through that real quick. So I will name their names, and when I call your name for your lettering, I want you to come up and just kind of circle around this way and pick up your pin or your bar, depending on what you got. This first pile is pins for the first time. The second pile is bars for second time. So if you are a first-time letter winner, just take a pin. And if you are a returning letter winner, take a bar. And it's going to be all of you that are going to come through here at least once. So here we go. All right, so these are the students that have earned letters for the first time. So they will come up and get their letters, and then they will stand up here for a quick photo, and they are Hallie Abraham, Kaylin Breath, Jose Godinez, Salvador Godinez, Daniel Godinez, Brooklyn Lux, Naomi Quijano, Matthias Rohr, and Blake Schultz. Come on up here. Stand up right here. Stand up right here. Yeah, I know you guys don't want to have your pictures taken, but there are people that want to take your pictures, so. Keep going over there, right on the other side of the pole, please. Right over here. Yep. Stand right up in front of the stage, right here. These are the first time letter winners. We do have an official photographer in the house taking pictures, so I want to make sure that they get all of the pictures that we need, so. All right, very good, thank you very much. Okay, now, everyone else on stage is a returning letter winner. So they will receive a bar. You take the wrong one, didn't you? It's all right. They will receive a bar that they can add to the pin that they've already earned. Also, first-time letter winners, you are also, I forgot, entitled to a chenille, which is a patch that you sew on your letter jacket. And you can see me later this week, and we'll get that squared away. The letter club takes care of those for us. So, all right, so here we go. Deep breath. And I'm going to mispronounce some names. If I do, I apologize. I always do, especially. I'm just going to, just by grade, so. And actually, I think we'll do it by grade. We'll start with the seniors. Maddie Becker, Daniela Chavez, Kale Danielson, Mason Goman, Justin Holmquist, Ben Larson, Jennifer Lemus, Vivian LaRue, Mohammed Malik, Ellie Pfeiffer, Ashton Rosno, Itzel Salazar, Xander Terway, and Zaire Wood. These are the senior returning letter winners. And they're going to come back up here in a little bit. Okay, once you're all standing there together, I'll give you about 10 seconds. We scooch down just a little bit so we don't have some poles in the face here. We've got the microphone stand here. Go ahead, go on over there. All right, very good. Okay, juniors. Juniors, Esperanza Andrade, Caleb Bitz, Brenda Mateo, Austin Breath, Mirna Garcia Rodriguez, Jesus Godinez Solis, Evan Hebert, Alexis Johnson, Layla Johnson, Corey Kruger, Jose Mata Contreras, Annalie Mendoza, Emily Moe, Miguel Morales Ortiz, Ruby Milner, Shelby Pfeiffer, Ceci Ramirez, Zuleika Reyes, Kimberly Rodriguez, Camden Terraway, Megan Weber. Those are your juniors, returning letter winners.
Check the bar.
I thought this year's senior class was big, assuming that they all come back, which I hope and pray that they do. I hope I haven't given them a reason not to. I'm just gonna let them stay where they are right now because it's a pretty big group. But these are our juniors that are letter winning return, so. Did you need some? You're good? All right, thank you. Very good. All right, sophomores. Sophomores, Amanda Berscheidt, Elizabeth Bitts, Maria Buncher, Eva Detterman, Kimberly Fausta Martinez, Elise Gamrod, John LaRue, David Leach, Ella Lepetsky, Savannah McCoy, Kusi Kyo, Morgan Speaker, Haley Wielenberg, and Caleb Zinter. Grab yourself a bar. And there should be enough bars, and I don't see the... All right, bad news, freshmen, I ran out of bars. But I have more on my desk, I'm not going to go get them right now, I'm sorry. So I will still want you to come out here though, but these are the sophomores. Wait, freshmen, you already got your pins. Good job, Mr. Speer. Freshmen were already recognized because they were first time letter winners, so we have gotten everybody. All right, I thought I had counted correctly. All right, thank you very much, sophomores. All right, every year we give out a Most Improved Award. Actually, we're not there yet. Every year I give out a medal for someone who has helped me with different technical issues, like setting up things, and there are several of you in here that have done that, but I have a senior in particular that has been helping me since he was a seventh grader, and he's won this award before, but he's gonna win it again. This is the LPGE Band Tech Award. It goes to Ashton Rosno. This is a recognition award. Every year I have someone who comes in and helps me try to be organized. And my wife is laughing hysterically right now. So, touche, honey. But I give a thanks medal to my teacher assistant every year. And this year my teacher assistant is Vivian LaRue. I have asked my cameraman to send me these pictures, so if you don't want to get up and take a picture, somebody is taking pictures with a very nice camera, and all you have to do is reach out, and I will do my best to get those to you. So, all right, every year, we recognize someone for showing considerable improvement year on year. That means they go from one level to another, and people recognize it. And I actually let the band vote on this one, and I was very pleased when I saw that the results were pretty much in line with who I thought it would be. So this year's 2022 Most Improved Award goes to Salvador Godinez. Now, you know, there is a pecking order. We have the John Philip Sousa Award, which is given out at every school in the nation. We have what I call the Director's Award, which is technically the Patrick S. Gilmore Award, but we can't call it that because if we do, we have to buy their award. And if we have to buy their award, they cost about $100 a piece. And I gave out three of them tonight. So we decided to call it the Director's Award. But I also give the band an opportunity, and it's not necessarily a duplicate award winner, to say, hey, you recognize someone in the band. You recognize seniors who you think have been just role models and have really embodied the spirit of the band and had a positive attitude and always been there. And I have two individuals that have won that award tonight. And so this year, the 2022 People's Choice Award goes to, and I have to carry two of them now, so, Muhammad Malik and Zaire Wood. Their names are also engraved on this. You can take this to your graduation open house. You can coordinate who's this who's. And you can just get it from each other, but I'll hold this for you for the photo. So here we go. Beginning with, and actually, let me just take a moment to talk about my seniors. It says in the program there are 15. Apparently, I don't know how to count. There are only 14. But I'm thankful for that because I don't want to lose any more than I have to. Outstanding senior class, one of the best I've had across the board. They're all strong contributors to this group, an effort, attitude, musical ability. You saw a good chunk of them play the Molly on a Shore tonight, so you can. You can attest to that. You've heard them play. In the next piece, you're going to hear quite a few of them soloing. So these next awards, to me, are, including the ones that I just gave, actually, are very equal in stature. And some of them have famous names on them. Some of them don't. But all of these seniors that I'm recognizing have just been tremendous. So every year, I give out this, what I call the Director's Award, which, again, nationally has a different name that we're not supposed to use. But I have three individuals that have won that award this year, and I'd like them to come up and be recognized. And they are Ashton Rosno, Kale Danielson, and Maddie Becker. Fun fact, I've been pronouncing Ashton's name wrong since he was a seventh grader, so tonight I'm trying to make up for it. Nearly every school in the nation gives out this next award. It's called the John Philip Sousa Award. It was established upon his death to honor the top band students in the districts across America. Originally, it's supposed to go to one person, but many, many schools, my school included, we have elected to give it out to the top male and top female in the group. And so this year, it is my privilege to present the John Philip Sousa Award, and they will receive a plaque, and they will also have a traveling trophy that they can take to their open houses to display. Their names are engraved on the trophy and will remain on the trophy for as long as we are here. So the 2022 John Philip Sousa Award winners are Vivian LaRue and Xander Tearaway. the People's Choice and Philip Sousa. We do not have a director's plaque as of yet, but we will be getting one. And then when we do, it'll be too late for you this year to have your open house, but your name will be recorded on the wall. People will know who you are years from now. They'll see your name engraved. So, okay, this is the part. I don't really like this part. It's very bittersweet for me, but it becomes more meaningful. It became more meaningful for me when I started to have classes where I saw them from seventh grade on, and this is one of those classes now I've had throughout their whole time here at Long Prairie. I have 14 amazing seniors, and I'm going to call their names off one by one, and they're going to come up, and I'm just going to take the time to present each of them with their commemorative senior keychain. It says LPGE Band Class of 2022. And you can do whatever you like with it, but this is yours to keep and remember forever. So here are those amazing individuals that are playing for the last time at a concert. And my application crashed. All right, woohoo. Let's bring that back up. And they are, as I said before. So as I call your name, please come up and stand in the front and just stay there and wait for me. Maddie Becker. Daniela Chavez Rodriguez. Kale Danielson. Mason Goman, Justin Holmquist, Benjamin Larson, Jennifer Limous Sanchez, Vivian LaRue, Mohammed Malik, Eliana Pfeiffer, Ashton Rosno, Itzel Salazar Cervantes, Xander Terway, and Zaire Wood. I was going to give them to you. It's okay, just hang on to it. You ruined the moment. No, I'm just kidding. All right, hold on. I would implore you to take a moment to read, if you get a chance here before we finish the concert, to read the program notes for the final piece we're playing tonight. This piece was suggested to me by the guest conductor, and I had not heard of it, surprisingly. It's been around for a while, but I have grown to really love this piece of music. And I'm going to indulge myself a little bit tonight. Not only am I going to have a guest conductor, I'm going to take my trombone, I'm going to sit with the band, and I'm going to play with my band tonight. And I'm gonna let someone else take the reins. You know, it's kind of symbolic because as they graduate and as our children grow up and leave the home, we're not hanging on anymore. We don't have the reins anymore. Maybe we do in such a way. I mean, my daughters, they still talk to me and ask me for advice, especially when they need money. But, you know, I always tell people my job is kind of like, it's like my suits are airplanes and I'm trying to get them off the ground to take flight. And then wherever they go is wherever they go. And after 6 years seeing them take off, it's tough. So it's almost symbolic that I'm turning the band over to someone else and I get to play with them tonight. So at this point, I'm gonna let him say a word or two before we finish out. So it is my pleasure to bring out once again my friend, Mr. Keith Wander.
Kind of strange to be at a concert and not having said anything until the end. It really is a special thing, these senior honor concerts. And as Mr. Speer said, you work with these students so long and they get to this night and then they move on. And to be asked to come in and conduct the last piece that they will have in the on this stage is very special for me. So thank you, Mr. Speer, for that. Mr. Speer. Whenever the seniors go, you always wonder, okay, what's going to happen next? And they can never be replaced. But there's always a crop coming in. Everything changes a little bit. And what your job as a band director to do is to keep the quality the same or better. And from what I've observed, Mr. Speer does a fantastic job with that. And like he said, I've known him since he was this age, a little bit younger. And as we've grown older, we have been student teacher, we have been colleagues, we both do the same thing. And everything that I've seen him do says that he is doing a fantastic job. And so I want to thank him again. And students, it has been an absolute pleasure this year. And I was wondering if I've been here too much this year. And as I was driving up the other day, the junior high kids were running past, heading out to the field, and one of them went past and yelled, "Hi, Mr. Wander." And I thought, yeah, I may have been here a little much this year, but it's been an absolute pleasure. Your children are absolutely fantastic. Your director is fantastic. Thank you so much for having me here. One thing about the piece that we're going to play, Pilates is not an exercise regimen in this case. Pilates is a mountain. This piece was written in 2002, and prior to that, I've been to the top of Mount Pilates a number of times. And up until 2002, there was no mention of the dragons of Pilates. After 2002, you walk up there and there are plaques everywhere for all of the different dragons that are on top of the mountain. So this was inspired to Mr. Reinecke, and Mr. Reinecke's piece inspired the people on the mountain to change what they do. Music creates art, art creates music. Thank you so much, and we have one more piece for you.
Thank you. shed. She was looking kind of dumb with her finger and her thumb in the shape of an L on her forehead. Well, the years start coming and they don't stop coming. Fed to the rules and I hit the ground running. Didn't make sense not to live for fun. Your brain gets smart but your head gets dumb. So much to do, so much to see. So what's wrong with taking the back streets? You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
And all that glitters is gold.
Only shooting stars break the mold. It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. You're bundled up now, wait till you get older. But the media men beg to differ. Judging by the hole in the satellite picture, the ice we skate is getting pretty thin. The water's getting warm, so you might as well swim. My world's on fire, how about yours? That's the way I like it, and I'll never get bored. Hey now, you're an all-star. Get your game on, go play. Hey now, you're a rock star. Get the show on, get paid.
In the back streets, you'll never know.